While the specific details of the decision are likely a few weeks away, the U.S. Court of Federal Claims has denied an infamous Blue Origin lawsuit, upholding NASA's decision to award SpaceX a contract to create a Starship-derived moon lander. The ruling ends almost 7 months of delays, explicitly caused by protests and lawsuits filed by competitors Dynetics and Blue Origin. Protests were first filed with the U.S. Government Accountability Office, about a week after NASA announced in April 2021 that SpaceX would build the human landing system. Both protests were denied in July, but Blue Origin ultimately chose to double down and filed a lawsuit against NASA and SpaceX in August, kicking off a process guaranteed to cause several more months of delays. Blue Origin, the aerospace company founded by Amazon's Jeff Bezos, filed a lawsuit against NASA over a contract to develop a human landing system to return astronauts to the moon by 2024 under the Artemis program. In April, NASA awarded SpaceX a $2.9 billion HLS contract to develop a lunar-optimized Starship. Blue Origin's, the national team, which includes Lockheed Martin, Northrop Grumman and Draper, submitted a lunar lander proposal, requesting $5.9 billion to develop it. Dynetics also filed a proposal, requesting $9 billion. The agency opted to only select one proposal due to budget constraints. NASA's decision to contract with SpaceX alone defied most expectations, especially when the space agency ultimately explained that SpaceX's Starship proposal was half the price of the next best option, while simultaneously offering better management and more convincing technical expertise. More importantly, rather than attempting to deliver the bare minimum specifications NASA requested from HLS bidders, SpaceX's Starship moon lander went above and beyond, enabling potentially revolutionary performance, magnitudes better than Blue Origin or Dynetics offerings. Based on their redacted GAO protests, both of which contained a litany of frivolous arguments, and dubiously relevant and self-unaware jabs at SpaceX, Blue Origin and Dynetics were furious about their losses. Aside from one minor nitpick, GAO wholly denied both protests, at which point Blue Origin took the matter to federal court, rather than slink home, tail between its legs. In the interim between protest filing and GAO's decision, Blue Origin also repeatedly tried to go behind NASA's back by having sympathetic members of Congress tack on amendments to unrelated bills that would have forced the space agency to select a second HLS lander without guaranteeing the additional funding needed to pay for it. Blue Origin owner and former Amazon CEO Jeff Bezos even sent an unsolicited letter and proposal to NASA offering to pony up $2 billion of the $6 billion it requested to develop a NASA moon lander. SpaceX, on the other hand, did what NASA's HLS request for proposal explicitly asked of bidders and proposed to pay half of its Starship lander development costs in its original proposal. While Blue Origin instead attempted to milk as much money from NASA as possible, under the delusional premise that NASA would then negotiate for a cheaper deal. The U.S. Court of Federal Claims ruled against Jeff Bezos' Blue Origin on Thursday in the company's lawsuit versus NASA over a lucrative astronaut lunar lander contract, awarded to Elon Musk's SpaceX earlier this year. Federal Judge Richard Hertling sided with the defense in his ruling, completing a months-long battle after Blue Origin sued NASA in August. NASA said in a statement that work with SpaceX will resume as soon as possible, now that the ruling has been issued. There will be forthcoming opportunities for companies to partner with NASA in establishing a long-term human presence at the moon under the agency's Artemis program, the agency added. A Blue Origin spokesperson said in a statement to CNBC that the company's lawsuit highlighted the important safety issues with the human landing system procurement process that must still be addressed. Returning astronauts safely to the moon through NASA's public-private partnership model requires an unprejudiced procurement process, alongside sound policy that incorporates redundant systems and promotes competition. Blue Origin remains deeply committed to the success of the Artemis program, the company said. SpaceX did not respond to a request for comment on the ruling. Musk, in a tweet replying to CNBC's report on the ruling, posted a photo from the 2012 movie, Dread. NASA in April awarded SpaceX with the sole contract for the agency's human landing system program, under a competitive process. Worth $2.9 billion, the SpaceX contract will see the company use its Starship rocket to deliver astronauts to the moon's surface for NASA's upcoming Artemis missions. SpaceX was competing with Blue Origin and Dynetics for what was expected to be two contracts, before NASA only awarded a single contract due to a lower-than-expected allocation for the program from Congress. Blue Origin quickly protested the decision with the U.S. Government Accountability Office, but the GAO in late July denied the company's appeal, leading Bezos' space company to escalate its legal action. Bezos is also the founder of e-commerce giant Amazon. A redacted version of Blue Origin's lawsuit revealed the company's complaint focused on proving that NASA wrongly awarded the contract to only SpaceX and disregarded key flight safety requirements in the process. Hertling's ruling dismissed Blue Origin's claims. The court's opinion is currently sealed, as the case contains information proprietary to the companies, but the parties were ordered by Hertling to deliver proposed redactions by November 18 to publicly release the opinion. NASA's work with SpaceX on the HLS contract was halted during the lawsuit, but is scheduled to resume Monday. Later on, weeks into the lawsuit, redacted court filings revealed that Blue Origin had abandoned most of the arguments it put forth in its GAO protest and was instead leading with the claim that a few minor but potentially valid violations of contracting rules made by NASA and SpaceX in their limited post-award negotiations. It's now clear that the presiding judge was far from convinced by that argument, instead ruling entirely in SpaceX and NASA's favor, and upholding the space agency's HLS procurement process. It remains to be seen if the judge was at all swayed by any of the several arguments Blue Origin threw at the wall. Something that the court's final redacted decision will hopefully clarify when it's released around November 18. In the meantime, it's unclear when exactly NASA and SpaceX will be able to finally get back to work on HLS. Prior to the court's decision, NASA's voluntary stay of performance, preventing collaboration with SpaceX on its HLS contract, was scheduled to expire on November 8. SpaceX remains the sole winner of the lunar lander development contract to return NASA astronauts to the moon. It is no secret that SpaceX founder Elon Musk and Blue Origin founder Jeff Bezos have a competitive rivalry in the modern space race. In response to the news report, Musk tweeted a meme from the 2012 movie, Judge Dredd, that says in bold letters, "You have been judged." However, it is unclear whether NASA will accept proposals again for HLS development, especially after Blue Origin officially lost the lawsuit. "Not the decision we wanted, but we respect the court's judgment, and wish full success for NASA and SpaceX on the contract," Jeff Bezos tweeted. Thanks for watching this video, and it's a super interesting topic. If you like this, make sure to subscribe. If you have any crazy ideas about what we should cover in next video, please comment it below, and we'll see if we can get to it. So thanks again for watching and goodbye.